Well, Lily, a very big departure here for Clements Ribeiro. They're renowned for their very bright, bold colours, aren't they? And we've got some very understated sort of black and white monochrome here.
It's quite Aztec, isn't it? It looks a little bit Indian.
It does. I had a quick chat with Inácio before the show. Inácio Ribeiro, one of the designers. Of course, it's Suzanne Clements and Inácio Ribeiro, a married couple who met at college. And he said that they were inspired by the dance marathons of the 1930s, which I think sounds
really?
Quite glamorous.
That's very glamorous. It's beautiful, actually.
They've made their name, of course. They've only been showing for about 3 years now, but they made their name, of course, with those lovely stripy cashmere knits in bold colours.
Yes.
And this is reflected, that kind of really strong use of
beautiful
vivid shades.
Beautiful textures as well. I like the hair. It's quite romantic.
It's beautiful.
Flat shoes.
Oh, flat shoes. They're very big for autumn, aren't they?
They are. They are.
This organ music.
I know, this is a good addition.
Now you've modelled on the catwalk, haven't you? What's it like up there? I mean, it must be an incredibly terrifying experience. I know I couldn't do it. That sea of faces.
It is terrifying. I think a backstage is more so because it's so crazy. Everyone's running around manically and there's a sort of an adrenaline rush I think is running on. And it's quite fun once you're out there, once you've done it.
Especially Isabella Blow from the Sunday Times. Sorry to interject
no,
there,
that's
but
fine.
One of the fashion's eccentrics, I think.
Great hat.
You were saying, of course, backstage.
Backstage. It's a lot of fun, especially for London Fashion Week. Some shows maybe are a little bit more boring, but London Fashion Week is so exciting and everyone just loves doing it.
Now, the hair here is rather unusual.
It is.
You don't have a lot of control over how they make you look, do they?
Never. And you never have control over what you wear either. It's usually just put on a rail for you. You're lucky to get what you may like.
Now, Clements Ribeiro are doing something quite different to the things we've seen so far at London Fashion Week. Although white has been a very predominant colour, they've done very strong shapes. It's quite bold. Everyone else has been quite soft looking with floaty fabrics for summer, but these are actually quite strong shapes.
Yes, they are for summer. It's very nice, though. It's nice to have something different. I think that's what most designers are aiming for, something a bit different that stands out from the rest, possibly.
It's almost like a zebra print.
That
there.
Is, a little bit of a zebra animal-type print.
And these pleated skirts, of course,
yes.
are taking on the schoolgirl look that
exactly.
Has been very strong for autumn-winter, taking that on for summer with a kilt there in the winter white.
And to the knee.
Do you think that's a flattering look? I mean, you're obviously tall with great legs, but do you think that most women can wear that?
I think it's debatable. I really do. I think it is a length and it is a style that can be slightly unflattering. But it depends. It depends how it's cut and depends. That's the beauty of a designer outfit, possibly. It's cut so well, so it can look good on any shape. Whereas sometimes the high street tends to be cut a little bit less.
What a great coat.
Yeah, that's amazing.
I don't want to fall over in that one. The people are thinking of a zebra crossing.
I quite like the eye makeup as well. It's a bit orange. Quite dramatic.
I look like that when I wake up in the morning.
I know it. We put concealer on to get rid of that stuff, don't we?
Now, of course, makeup on the catwalks isn't what we're expected to wear in our life,
no.
Isn't it? It's something that it's done very creatively just to portray an image, isn't it?
Exactly. I think, once again, to stand out, to get a little bit of attention, trying to be creative with... Because so many designers... Well, it depends, I suppose. Each designer is different, but a lot of the time the collection can be quite outrageous, and the makeup is as well. It may not necessarily mean that's for the normal woman to wear, but an adaptation is made, isn't it, from the catwalk onto the... rails of stores.
I'm sure we'll start seeing those colours coming through, the stronger colours of eyeshadow.
Yeah, I think we probably will.
Look at these little ankle socks. I can't cope with those for grown women, I'm afraid.
No.
They're fine on 5-year-olds, but they're really
it's
not.
It's true, isn't it? It's a very girly look.
Now, I know Manolo Blahnik's done the shoes here.
Oh,
has he? He's one of the most prominent shoe designers in the world, and I think probably if you look along the front row, almost every fashion editor would be wearing
would
them.
Would be wearing them. Can't leave home without your Manolos.
More grey. This has been a very strong colour for winter, and it's definitely going to continue through, I think.
Yeah, it seems to be. It's interesting that grey's been so prominent this winter. I read somewhere that a lot of the fabric warehouses, the actual retail, or the where the designers would go to buy the fabric, supplied a lot of grey, and perhaps that's the reason.
Mm. Of course, they have to buy their fabrics or choose their fabrics normally about 18 months before the collection is shown to the press. So that's a long, long way to be planning ahead, and they have to commit to probably hundreds of metres of fabric to go into production. And this pretty peasant top, which Nicole Fari did last summer,
yes,
this lovely gathered shape. It's very soft and romantic.
It is, isn't it? I like that. The music's very romantic too.
Most of this is actually quite wearable. If you take away the avant-garde hairstyles and the wacky makeup, the clothes themselves are really quite wearable. And probably quite suitable for a British summer, I reckon.
Yes. it's covering all bases, isn't it? Whatever the weather could be like.
And most designers would show a jacket like that in their winter collections.
They would.
Clements Ribeiro are obviously very conscious that we tend only to have a few days of sunshine in this country.
Yeah, that seems to be a big factor, doesn't it?
There's Erin O'Connor, the Manchester-born model, who has really taken the fashion world by storm, along with Karen Elson, hasn't she?
Yes, she's beautiful.
I think she's just won a very big contract with Chanel.
So really? Oh,
Brit girls are very, very big.
Yeah. I also saw Georgina.
Georgina Cooper.
Yeah, it was lovely.
She, of course, was one of the girls that really won over the fashion world when three of the British models, very young girls, won the Gucci campaign last season.
Yeah.
This is quite a nice shaped jacket, a very relaxed tailoring with the kind of safari style pockets.
Yeah.
It's almost a carry through from the camouflage combat trouser look that All Saints have made popular.
Yeah, I live up in Notting Hill Gate and I feel sort of out of touch when I don't own a pair of combat trousers, but...
There's Kirsty Hume, another one of the biggest models
beautiful.
At the moment. Now, that is all her real hair. I can tell you her hair reaches right down to her waist.
Oh, how beautiful.
It's very nice to see these girls in London on the catwalk. A few seasons ago, we'd never have attracted the big names like this.
I think London Fashion Week has really caught up with the rest of the world. It's funny because a lot of the big designers in Paris are actually English, aren't they?
Absolutely, we've got John Galliano, Stella McCartney, yeah. Alexander McQueen, Etche Givenchy.
Yeah. I like this song.
How important is it for you to like the song or the music that's playing? If you're walking down the catwalk, it must be really hard.
Oh, it's very important. I find that makes, that gives you the energy, not even the energy, but the motivation to really work the outfit. If the music is... Oh, if you just don't like it, it doesn't make you want to do it as well.
Do you think that's why a lot of models don't smile?
Perhaps.
They don't like the music.
That and they're very nervous.
Now, I love this beautiful French lace, embroidered tulle, and then layered with other sheer fabrics. It's such a pretty look.
It is, isn't it? Oh, I do like that as well.
Another big name model at the moment within the fashion industry, certainly a girl called Suniva there. I think the big, big name supermodels, the girls like Linda Evangelista and Christy Turlington, are probably not, they don't really do catwalk anymore, except for Dior and Galliano, do they?
No, I don't think they do.
Most of them just do big advertising campaigns.
Exactly.
And just enjoy their bank balance.
Yes. Reap the rewards of the 80s.
It's very pretty, these little trails of organza.
Pretty. And it's layered, I love that. Layered effect.
It's become a lot more wearable, hasn't it? Transparency. It used to be a look that was just for the catwalks and no one ever put it into production.
No.
But now designers have found ways of using these lovely translucent fabrics and layering. And you'd never have thought of putting that peach with black.
No, never. But it actually looks very nice.
I'm sure, though, there'd still be some smart Alex who'd say, but she's forgotten to put her clothes on. She's going out in her underwear.
She's in a slip. I remember wearing a slip dress once and on my way to a party and I had to stop at a bank machine and I got out of the cab and went to the bank machine and there was a man standing behind me and he said, gosh, you're brave to come out in your nightie. And I thought, oh no. It's fashion, darling, don't you know?
It's acceptable in London, but I'm not sure it would work in a country pub in the middle of
summer. No, it wouldn't. No, it probably wouldn't.
I know, I had a quick look backstage, and it's a lovely cut work here. They've kind of burnt out holes in this fabric.
Wow.
With the layered underneath.
And pink as well.
This corally pink is really, really coming through as a strong theme. And aquamarine as well is another lovely colour for summer that's coming through.
I love aquamarine. It's a very summery colour to me.
Now, you were born and brought up in Hawaii, weren't you?
I was,
so
yes.
You're used to really strong summers. What do you find sort of summer clothes here? And do you find it frustrating that you can't wear pretty summer clothes?
I do sometimes. And I find that, gosh, I just have to wear them anyway. Oh, that's gorgeous. I love that. That's very pretty colour and fabric.
That lovely ruching.
No, I find the English summers very frustrating, especially this past summer, because there really was about 4 or 5 days of summer. And I think it's a little depressing. We're all going off to the shops looking at beautiful summer dresses and little summery clothes, not being able to even wear them because it's raining and cold.
It's interesting fringing here.
Oh, that is.
Looks like a beautiful silk velvet that they've cut little holes in and made a... It's almost like a flapper dress from the 20s,
isn't it? It is. It's very 20s. The length of it as well.
And continuing through yet more bias cutting, where the fabric is cut on the cross to give it that lovely drape around the body.
And that always, that I find that's a very flattering cut for any woman's shape, because it tends to just fit your body, no matter what your body's like.
Yes, you're allowed to have curves when you're wearing these, aren't you? You don't have to have these androgynous, boyish figures that a lot of the models have. Well, you've been watching the Spring Summer 99 collection from Clements Ribeiro. Thanks very much for joining me, Lily.
Thank you.